to say it was all R-Truth, but Cesaro with a great counter.
Gotta look at this. This is what Truth learned. Cesaro goes for that.
Sensation in trouble here. Truth hooks the outside leg, and R-Truth gets it.
Excellent. Excellent.
Here's your winner.
Excuse me, R-Truth. Unfortunately, disappointing loss at Survivor Series when the title is on the line. Tonight, non-title match versus Antonio Cesaro. You picked up the victory. Where does this leave, R-Truth?
I picked up the victory indeed. Just like I told you, every dog got his day. But see, you got to understand, it ain't the size of the dog in the fight. It's the size of the fight in the dog. Survivor Series, that was Antonio Cesaro's. Tonight, this dog bites. Now, this dog is on a hunt for the U.S. title. USA!
Excuse me, Rosa.
Hi.
Hi, how are you? Just noticing that you're watching the Alberto Del Rio match.
I'm watching Alberto Del Rio and Sin Cara.
Is anything in particular you're noticing from this match so far?
Well, Alberto looks very strong. But Sin Cara does too, so. And I'm just, you know, watching the match to pick up on some moves in their repertoire, scouting for a Primo and Epico.
Oh, naturally, naturally. Anything in particular you found that Primo and Epico could use in their repertoire?
Maybe, but that's for me to know and for you not to find out. So vete! Vete, vete!
Sheamus got his title match.
Get
the
out.
World. This is just unfathomable.
I told you I was gonna win. Okay. Now I'm gonna do it.
Daniel Bryan wants to lock in the no lock. See if he can force the Big Show to tap out. Kane's taking a walk.
Do you blame him? As much as I hate this, I actually feel sorry for the Big Show.
I don't think
that
Daniel,
is strength.
I don't think Daniel Bryan can get the no lock on the Big Show choke slam.
It's a flying goat.
Excuse me. Impressive victory tonight over the tag team champions. You also sent a message to Sheamus regarding TLC. Any further comments?
Further comments? No, I just want Sheamus to really think about something. You know, he's in that barbaric Irish mode where, oh yeah, I'm ready, fella, bring it, I want him to think really hard. Last time he hit me with that chair over 30 times, I didn't have a chair in my hand. I couldn't fight back. Now you're going to give a 7-foot, 400-pound, sadistic giant a steel chair? Guess after I crush up all that ginger, I'll have to make me some gingerbread, won't I?
Zane, I don't think I have to tell you as a scouting report, this is what you've got to avoid facing this young, exciting man from Ghana, Africa.
This is it now, crucial.
Trouble in Paradise connects.
That's it.
Sandow down, Kingston into the cover, and Wade Barrett, will that be your fate when you challenge Kofi Kingston for the Intercontinental title?
The Intercontinental champion, Kofi Kingston.
Well, let's face it, your best isn't even going to be good enough to defeat me. And the next time you defend that championship, it's going to be the last. Because you're going to become the next victim of the great Barrett Barrage.
Kofi's statement win tonight on SmackDown, defending your title against Damian Sandow, but then the emergence of Wade Barrett, who was on commentary. He's had your number the last two times. Yeah. What are your thoughts?
Well, hey, first and foremost, I mean, yes, Wade Barrett has had my number on Monday. He showed me the levels to which I need to stoop to play the game with Wade Barrett. You understand what I'm saying? I know the rules now. Trust me when I tell you that next time that me and Wade meet, it's not going to be good news for Wade. I guarantee you that.
He told us after Monday Night Raw on Backstage Fallout that every time he faces you, he'll always beat you. What do you have to say
about
that?
That's what he said, huh? Well, I guess we'll find out next time, right? We'll find out what happens next time, okay? Like I said, I know the game that Wade wants to play. I understand all the rules now. He doesn't want a fair fight. He wants a scrap. That's what he wants. That's what he's going to get.